We just arrived to Shijomae Station. This is the station for the Toyosu Fish Market. Many people misunderstand that Toyosu Fish Market is located in Toyosu Station. However, it's in Shijomae Station, which is two stations away from Toyosu Station. If you are heading from Toyosu Station, it costs 189 Japanese yen if you use the train. Today, market is open. It's open from 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. So they close early. If you're planning to visit here during the nighttime, you gotta be careful. They have coin lockers, but seems like not that many. Still, there are several spots are open though. Tsukiji Fish Market is a really popular fish market in Tokyo. They have 83 years history. However, they decided to move to Toyosu in 2018, and this is a new fish market. Even they moved the fish market, still Tsukiji Market is more popular compared to Toyosu Market. So, does it worth visiting Toyosu Market? Let's explore, and let me explain what we have here. Toyosu Market contains by three parts. Firstly, let's explore this fish intermediate wholesale market. Each building is really big, and we are hitting that building over there. Let's see how long it will take walking from station to the building. Well, last time when I was here was about 3 years ago. I'm wondering if they changed the inside or not. In 3 years, we had pandemic and also Tokyo Olympic as well. It was a chaotic year. And here we go, we arrived to wholesale marketplace. It took about 5 minutes walking. Actually, 6 minutes. Inside, you can learn about the fish market and also about the fish. For example, what's nerimono? Well, if you love California roll, you have eaten this. Processed seafood made from fish minced or paste such as kamaboko or satsumage. Yes, imitation crab, it's a nerimono. And this is the car they usually use inside the fish market. The last time when I visited here, I didn't realize, but they have the number plate. Interesting. And also, you can learn Chinese characters. Ah, interesting. I didn't know how to call Samma in English, Pacific Sorry. Well, I'm learning English here though. Wow, this is a real size Maguro fish. 288 centimeters. It's huge. Here we go, we are at second floor. Here, it seems like it's a shopping street. However, many places are closing though. And this place seems like that's it. I'm wondering if travelers are having fun or not though. Here, still more stores are open. And wow, they have Otani Shohei's t-shirts as well. And the fish magnet, place it in the refrigerator. Also, the sushi key holder. Okay, seems like we can go upstairs. Last time I didn't go. Wondering what we have. And also, wondering why no one here. Kinda scary. Oops! Oh. You have to be careful. There is a step. Oh, I see. They have park over here. Oh my goodness. Literally, no one. But really beautiful. In front of you, that's Rainbow Bridge. If you're heading to Odaiba, you will use that bridge. Probably most of the travelers missing this place. If you visit Toyosu, don't forget to visit this upstairs square. There are just too many rainy days in June and July, so. Yep, it's a little bit cloudy, but much better compared to raining, right? I love the weather. Okay, so that's it for the first building. Let's explore the second and the third building. After that, I'm planning to eat some seafood. So,
Let's keep walking. I finally found a person over there. Seems like he's working over here though, because of his uniform. Next, let's go to the fish wholesale market observation gallery. Please keep to the left. Yes, in Japan, whenever you walk, just walk the left side. So this is the place where the tuna auction exists. Here, there are many seafood restaurants and sushi restaurants, and it's crowded. Uni bowl, 6,600 Japanese yen. Sushi, 6 pieces, 2,900 Japanese yen. This restaurant, the fried prawn Teishoku, is 2,400 Japanese yen. And look at this one, the big prawn, 4,800 Japanese yen. This is the fancy one. This place, omakase, 3,600 Japanese yen. And here, tempura, 3,000 Japanese yen. Well, I was born and raised in Japan. To be honest, those prices are a little bit expensive compared to the regular place. It's more like a, you know, tourist place. Pretty similar price with Tsukiji. Here, this is the tuna auction place. Sweet. Still, this big maguro is here. This is the biggest tuna fish they've ever had in this market. 496 kilogram, 2.88 meter. It's huge. Oh, I didn't realize, but even you don't understand Japanese, there is a QR translator over here. So maybe you can understand what it says. And it's the tuna auction place. You can see the tuna auction from the window. As you can see, the fish market is already over. Usually, they start the market from 4:30 a.m. So if you want to see the market, you have to come over here between 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. However, there is no train. So yeah, you have to take taxi. If you want to see how it looks like, here is a QR code. You can check it. And those are the hand gestures they use. Oh, interesting. We usually use number 3 like this, but here, it 3 is like this. Also, we usually don't use the hand gesture 6, 7, 8, 9, but here, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So if you expect to watch the real fish market, then you gotta be careful of the time. So here is a history of Japan fish market. It started from early Edo period, 1644, near the Nihonbashi. Nihonbashi is located near Tokyo Station, so it's a bit different compared to Tsukiji. In 1923, there was a great Kanto earthquake and everything was broken down. But after 16 days, already the fish market is back. Even the temporary one, the place is pretty big. In 1934, finally, they moved to the Tsukiji fish market. They spent 6 years to build it. In 1940, they finished the auction because of the water. But in 1950, they restarted the auction. It was a history about Tsukiji fish market. And then about 4 years ago, they moved to Toyosu. Here, there is a long history behind it. So if you love learning about Japan history, yeah, this is really interesting place to visit. And now let's go to the last building, the Fruits and Vegetable Observatory Gallery. Ah, it became more sunny days. So happy. Sweet. I'm planning to travel more and more places. Hopefully, you guys feel like virtual traveling with me. I'm planning to post edited video if I can, 2 videos per week. If I don't make the live stream, but it will randomly be posted. So if you haven't, please don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification. Please hit the bell button. Arigatou. And now we are at the fruits one. Last time, I think I didn't come over here. So let's see what we have. Oh wait, this place looks familiar. So maybe I have. Oh, the fruits one, still, we see some people there. Maybe compared to the fish.
the fruits last longer.
The place, it's really quiet.
Oh, interesting. That's the takarabune. Treasure board, but usually it's gold, but here it's veggie and fruits. They made it every new year, wishing the good luck. And here, seems like still many people are working around.
Well, it's more fun visiting over here compared to that fish market because there are people and also the huge takarabune. However, I guess not that many popular because I see pretty much no one. So that's it for the Toyosu Fish Marketplace, but our adventure hasn't finished yet. Last time I couldn't visit, but there is a park beside the ocean. This place must be really beautiful, so let's explore the park by the ocean.
Never been to this area, so I'm excited. Oh, here! We already see the Odaiba, it's Fuji TV. Seems like it's pretty close to Odaiba, huh? And finally we are here, it's Toyosu Gururi Park. Wow, it's a beautiful park by the ocean. So we are here, there's a playground and the park restaurants and the barbecue area. There is a big slide and also we can see the rainbow bridge. Sweet! Since not so many people using this playground, let's try the slide. Wow! Kid must love this place.
Sweet!
Well, I'm not sure how crowded this place will be, but yeah. Seems like it's a good park, especially visiting here during the weekday. Wow, beautiful place. Must feel good sleeping over here. Nice. I've been living in Tokyo for a while, but I didn't know we had this kind of place. If you live in Tokyo, maybe you can visit here. There is a parking as well. I believe those are the barbecue spots, but maybe they have it on the weekend. Oh, there is a restaurant. Oh my goodness, smells so good. So that's a barbecue spot. Even on the weekday, so many people are enjoying barbecue. Sweet. Oh, they have a bar too, however, it's closed. You know, barbecue is not for solo travelers because the amount is a lot, so hopefully I can find other restaurant. Let's see. You know what, I'm so happy. Couldn't find a restaurant, but instead I found this. It's the rental cycle port. You know, it was far from the station, so I'm so happy that I can rent a bike. You can just download the app and you can rent a bike. 30 minutes, 165 Japanese yen. Yep. If I walk back, it would take 30 minutes, so sweet. Okay, so this guy would be good. After I reserve it, place the start, and I just need to read the QR code. And it's open. How simple is that? It's the e-bike, so really useful. Let's go back to the Toyosu station. Oh, by the way, here's the parking price. On weekday, 30 minutes, 200 Japanese yen. On weekend, 30 minutes, 500 Japanese yen. Oh, if you visit here on the weekday, 30 minutes, 200 Japanese yen? Not bad. All right, let's go back to Toyosu Station and find the food. Many places don't have the bike lane, but this place has. So
It's much easier cycling over here. Already we are back to the station. I got the video request of the Toyosu station and also the Lalaport. So why don't we visit there and let me film it. By the way, if you have the video request, please let me know in the comment down below. Alright, so let's keep biking.
Here we go. Seems like it looks like the same station, but this is Shin Toyosu Station, where the Team Lab exists. Oh my goodness, compared to Toyosu Station, there are so many people. Seems like there is a school trip. Haven't visited the Team Lab yet, but I will in the future and I will make video. Seems like many people are walking from Toyosu Station to Shin Toyosu Station for the Team Lab. Yeah, it's only one station away, so walking distance. Here we go, we arrived to Toyosu Station and the parking is over here too. Sweet! Toyosu Station is a big station. There are many places to eat and also places to live as well. That's why they couldn't make the fish market over here. So we are over here and there is a shopping mall over here. Well, on the way, I believe we can find many places to eat, so yeah, let's explore. There are many cafes and restaurants. Hopefully, I can find seafood since we are in Toyosu. Wow, it is huge. Oh, there is terrace seat. Do they have seafood? Oh, more like Italian restaurant, I think.
Let's go.
So seems like there is one restaurant have the seafood. Let me see. Oh, here. They had the lunch menu items, but seems like it finished. Oh, they have seafood, but it's Thai fish. I have an allergy on it, so let's find the different place. Oh, look at this. We are the farm. All you can eat veggie cafe for 60 minutes, 1,500 Japanese yen. Sounds like a good deal. There is a bookstore and let's try the other building. Hopefully we have a nice restaurant over here. I'm starving. We have many restaurants in the third floor and also first floor food court. It's my first time to visit here. Seems like it's a non-shopping mall. Oh my goodness, this Korean food restaurant looking pretty good. Well, but I'm here to eat the seafood, so no sundubu today. Oh my goodness, look at this Thai food restaurant. This street food plate. Wow, this must be good too. Well, maybe we can think about it. We don't have to eat the seafood only.
Yep.
Oh, here. So this is the place for seafood. They have sushi. 1,580 Japanese yen. And they have tempura. 1,958 Japanese yen. Also, they have fancy one. 3,580 Japanese yen.
Okay, why not?
Why don't we try these restaurants? Let's go.
Seems like a nice place.
Oh, interesting. They have a blowfish sashimi. And also, the sushi plates. Those are the tunas.
So many kinds.
I'm wondering if I should order this or this one over here. This one includes uni, but this one includes the blowfish. Oh wait, they have a Toyosu limited menu. This one includes the sushi and tempura. Also, I can add their sushi too. So maybe I will order this and I will add the uni. All right, here we go. So include the sushi and the tempura. I add the uni for the extra, so it costs 2,600 something. However, if you don't add it altogether, 2,000 Japanese yen. Since we are in Toyosu, I really wanted to eat the seafood. So let's eat. Itadakimasu. It's the salmon. Mecha oishii. Also, the shrimp tempura.
Well, since I can't eat the white fish, I asked them to change it to the crab butter.
Yep. Looks interesting, right? Let me see if it's good or not.
You know what? I was so ready to say
interesting,
but actually it was much sweeter than compared to the last time I tried. And yes, this is the one
I really wanted to eat.
That's uni.
Oishii.
Well, my most favorite sushi is sea urchin uni. What is your most favorite wine? I love ikura too, though. What? There is eggplant tempura. Huh, this one is one of my favorite as well. Eggplant's sweetness perfectly matches with tempura. Loving it. Also, this one comes with shrimp. And tuna. Well, tuna's quality, it's okay. Also, I guess this is a gobo burdock. Let me see. Maybe it's ginger. Yep, it was spicy. And here, this is a hijiki seaweed, bean, and also yam. It's really popular Japanese food. Perfectly matches with beer too. It's really gentle taste. I believe it's good for health, so that's why I always eat. So I hope. And this is chawan mushi. It's like Japanese pudding, but not cold, it's warm. Inside there is a crab meat. Yes.
Itadakimasu.
Mecha oishii. Yeah, compared to pudding, it's not sweet. It's more like a dashi flavor. It is really popular food. Basically, it's not really a dessert. Usually, we eat like, you know, miso soup. Last time during the live stream, I was eating this chawanmushi. And, you know, some people asked me about this. So, basically, this is really popular food in Japan. And pretty much, you know, every sushi restaurant, if you go, you can find this, even in the conveyor's restaurant as well. If you never tried it, maybe you can try that.
Ooh, that was pretty good, and I'm so full. Inside the shopping mall, really peaceful. Oh, really? There is a place to sit down outside too. Let's go. This Lalaport is more like American style. Oh, here we have a Kidzania Tokyo. It's kind of like amusement park for kids. They can experience many different kinds of jobs. Oh, inside the Daiso. Oh, also Toys R Us as well. Recently, we haven't seen many Toys R Us in Japan. Yeah, getting less, I believe. And Akachan Honpo, which is a really popular store for babies. It's like a baby R Us. And also there is a Baba Gump as well. The last time I went there was the Santa Monica Pierce one. I haven't been there for a while. Oh, so this is the entrance of the Kidzania. My first time to see that. Interesting. Wow, look at that. It's a huge AMF lights. Well, speaking of the Kidzania, I've never been there, but I've seen the photo that my nieces are going. Seems like they really enjoyed it. So maybe if you have a kid, you can try there. And the stores for kids' shoes. Ooh. Oh, here we have Starbucks. Oh my goodness, it became, what a beautiful day. Loving it. I'm so full. Actually, speaking of the price, it was about 2,500 Japanese yen. Well, I don't know. Compared to the regular food, it is expensive. However, after visiting the Toyosu market and then coming back here, eating that seafood with that price feels like maybe good deal or even cheaper. So in my conclusion, is it worth visiting Toyosu fish market? For me, it's okay, it's okay. If you're interested in Tsukiji fish market history, then probably you can visit there. But maybe for me, this Toyosu Lalaport was more fun compared to Toyosu fish market. Well, so maybe if you have a small kid, you can visit the Toyosu fish market and then also Team Lab and the Toyosu Lalaport. Yeah, because Toyosu fish market is an interesting place, but there are more many interesting places as well. Anyway, hopefully you could virtual travel to Japan and this info will be a help for your next Japan trip. There will be more small topics in the future videos, so if you love Japan, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. Big thank you to all of the Patreons. If you haven't, please check my Patreon account and also my Instagram as well. So see you in the next video. Se no go. Have a great day. Bye-bye.